Have you ever watched a YouTube video with your speakers dialed into that perfect loudness, and then the following video plays and you find yourself reaching to turn up the volume? Maybe it's your video that's too quiet. Well, I've done that. Anyways, that's why today I'm going to show you how and why you can master your mixes the right way for YouTube, not too loud and distorted, or too quiet, so you don't lose your audience with bad audio. We're going to do it all in DaVinci Resolve 17 with free loudness normalization tools, so make sure to stick around to the end because I promise you're gonna learn something new today. YouTube automatically turns your audio down if it's too loud, but it's not gonna turn it back up for you if it's too quiet. You can see how YouTube processes the sound in any video just by right-clicking and choosing Stats for Nerds. I don't know if they're trying to tell me something here, but take a look at the fourth stat down for normalized. If it says content loudness is a negative number, then this video could have been mixed louder, making it better for the viewer. The goal is to get that negative number as close to zero as possible without going over. It's kind of like bidding on that TV show The Price is Right. Now, if the content loudness is a positive number, that means it's too loud and YouTube has turned the mix down for you. And who wants YouTube turning down and messing with your finished masterpiece? Not me. All of this is measured and based on a standard of negative 14 integrated LUFS, also known as average LUFs. But what the heck are LUFs? LUFS, LUFS, that stands for loudness units relative to full scale. 1 decibel equals 1 LUF, and that's the slightest change that your ears can hear. The lower the LUF number, the quieter it is, and the higher the number, the louder it is. Side note, the term decibel, it comes from measuring how much signal was lost over a long telephone line. More specifically, a Bell telephone line, as in from Alexander Graham Bell, that's the dude that invented the phone. See, I told you were gonna learn something new. Anyways, that's decibels. LUFs, they're used to measure average volume over the entire length of a video based on how your ears actually hear the sound up in your head. Here in DaVinci Resolve, let's take a listen to what negative 20 decibel test tone sounds like over time. Okay, you can see we're at negative 20 dB over here on the mixer and the meter. Now let's change that up and listen to what it would sound like as beeps. So it's going to be the same test tone, just with air in between. And if you can probably tell right now, it doesn't sound quite as loud, right? But we are still hitting negative 20 dB on the meters. It's all about average over time. Now, the process of mastering the mix up to a specification like minus 14 LUFs, that's called loudness normalization, not to be easily confused with peak normalization, which if you've edited for very long, you've probably already used or heard of this. Loudness normalization brings up your average volume to a specific level over time, so we need to be using this for mastering our YouTube mixes. Peak normalization, on the other hand, that brings up everything to a specific peak in dBFS, decibels full scale, where zero is the maximum, over zero is red and wrong, and that's when distortion starts to happen. Now don't do this because this is old school, but if you wanted to peak normalize in the edit page, you could have right-clicked, said normalize audio levels, and chosen a normalization mode like sample peak program with it set to -9, hit normalize, and it brings the highest peak down to -9. But it brings it all down to that. It's not a loudness control, it's just basically a volume up and down. We don't want that for what we're doing today for mixing for YouTube, so we'll hit undo. And to loudness normalize our video, we go to the Fairlight page. Fairlight page is this little music note that's over here. And now that we're in here, I'm gonna show you two meters that make all this work. So if they're not open already, open up your mixer in the upper right and your meters as well. And if I play back, you'll see down here is the meter that you probably know and love from the edit page. It's an RMS meter, which means it's an average, but it's an average over a short period of time, versus the meter up here. This is our compound meter, our loudness meter, which gives us an integrated reading and a true peak, which are very important. We're going to talk about a lot today. But the main thing to note is that both of these are useful meters, the RMS one, the loudness meter, because they give us an objective look at how our sound actually is, not just basically how we're hearing it, but how it actually is, how the power is coming out, just like the vectorscope or waveform monitor would over on the color page when we're doing color. Hey, quick time out. If you're new here, welcome. I'm Chadwick. This is Creative Video Tips. It's all about helping you craft stories to make a difference and stand out. So if you're into that, please subscribe right now so you don't miss out on next week's tip. Maybe even hit the bell. Doesn't cost you a thing and you can unsubscribe at any time. I'm an editor that's super into DaVinci Resolve, so let's jump back into the computer right now so I can show you how this all works. One quick optional setup thing would be to go to your project settings, the little cog down here in the lower right, then go down to Fairlight and your target loudness level. Let's change this here to -14. OK, okay? Because we're doing YouTube, we're not doing broadcast TV. That's what negative 23 is for. We're gonna hit save, and what this is gonna do is it's gonna give us a color code of blue, yellow, and red that we're gonna get to next when we go to analyze our levels. Before we can figure out where we're gonna go with our levels, we need to see where we're actually at. And Resolve 17 has a great feature to bounce your entire mix to a new track and then analyze it. So that way you don't have to watch and listen to the whole thing to get an accurate reading, a loudness reading of what it is. So to bounce to a new track, we go up to timeline, bounce mix to new track, and then we're gonna say the destination track is gonna be a new track, new stereo track. We'll say okay. And real quickly, it's rendering out a new piece of audio, which is all of that mixed down for us. So you could solo it and preview it and listen to it if you wanted to. But what we're gonna do is use the analyze tool, which is done by right-clicking and say analyze audio levels. It's right above normalize audio levels, which we don't wanna use. And then we're gonna use the loudness standard, and we're gonna use the same loudness standard for all the parts of this video because this is the latest and greatest. It's the 1770-4 of the ITU. I think the default is -1 when you open it up, so make sure you change that to 4. All the others are dry from it, so why not just use the latest and greatest? We're gonna choose that. We'll say analyze, and then real quickly, without having to go through the whole 1 minute promo video here, we have reading. So this is -1.7 dBFS and -19.5 LUFs, which, as you know, we wanna hit -14, so we have quite a ways to go. This is way quiet for YouTube, and we're gonna fix that in the next section. Okay, well, that analyze feature is great. Obviously, we're not gonna have time to bounce the track every single time, so we're gonna delete that right now, and I'm gonna show you how the compound meters, the loudness meters work up here. And there's a couple things I wanna change off the bat that's gonna make your life a lot easier. Choose this little three-dot menu, and turn on lock metering to transport. What this is gonna do is every time you move the playhead around, it's gonna reset for you so you don't have to use the reset button. That's super helpful. The other one I wanna change under here is absolute scale. So instead of having 0 right here, which is a relative scale based off of your project settings, it's gonna be telling us what it is. I just wanna see what it is. So it's gonna change, so -14 is at the top, and our integrated reading is gonna tell us what our actual integrated reading is. I can do the math, I think. And then the other one is, let's change this to the standard of 1770-4, which is the latest and greatest. Okay, now that we've done that, all you need to do is go to the beginning of your video and play through the entire thing. Okay, there's no cheating it. You can't fast forward it, although I'm gonna cheat it and fast forward it for the tutorial's sake. But you, in reality, you just have to wait and let the thing play back, and that'll give you an integrated reading and a true peak reading. Say that 3 times fast. And I'll tell you what those are in a second, but let's hit start on this loudness meter and we'll hit play. And I will see you once this fast forwards. Okay, video's over. We have an integrated loudness reading of -19.8 LUFs, which is pretty close to what we got when we had bounced it. And then we also have a true peak up here of -1.7. Now, if you don't know what true peak is basically what's the loudest point in the video after it's been converted to analog. So is something gonna distort? Is it gonna go over 0 once it's converted to analog? This is what's gonna tell us that. So what our goal is now is we're gonna try to keep our true peak to -1.5. That's like a YouTube thing. Gives us a little bit of headroom when we compress it. So -1.5 is the max there. And then our integrated reading, we want that closer to -14, maybe -15. So, but here's the thing. Obviously, if you do a little math, at -14 and we're at -19.8, we need to go 5.8 up in decibels, but we only have 1.7 of headroom here before we would clip. So in the next section, I'm gonna show you the strategies that I would use to mix it. And the other thing I was gonna point out here is these colors. So we talked about in the project settings when we had set up our target loudness level to -14, that actually affects the colors of what these numbers are here. So blue means it's below our target, yellow means we're good and we're pretty close, and red, obviously that's bad. So let's avoid red at all costs, just like if you're using an RMS meter down there. So while this isn't a mixing tutorial, I do wanna give you a couple tricks to use to pull your overall level up to get closer to the -14 LUFs that you need for YouTube. And the first of those is compression. Compression reduces the dynamic range of your track or your clip. And the way you use it here in Fairlight, over in the mixer, go to dynamics and double click. And right in here, you've got it right in the middle. So I already have this set up for this vocal track on this lav. It was very dynamic, so I needed to bring my threshold down quite a bit. That's when it starts to kick in. So at negative 25.4 decibels is when it kicks in. And then the ratio. This ratio is actually pretty high. I generally wouldn't recommend you go over 3, but because there was so much variance in the dynamic range, I needed to go up to 5 on this. And then the makeup gain is basically, because we've squashed and lowered those peaks, the makeup gain is basically lifting back up to compensate for how much we've decreased the volume. So if we take a listen over here.
I grabbed Nate and I was like, hey, I got this idea. Can you help me flesh it out?
So basically we've pulled that level up quite a bit right there. And we can see over here, we're at negative 14 integrated LUFs on that little bit of playback. Of course, that's just the little section that we played, but you can see we're getting everything in a much tighter spot. So that's compression, and that's how you could use that. I would use that on most of your tracks, depending how dynamic and run and gun your shoot was. Another really simple to use tool to pull your level up is gonna be the fader. The fader basically is gonna say everything that's on a track, like everything that's on this track right here, if I push this up or down, that's gonna push that entire track's volume for each clip that's on it up or down. So in this instance, on this one, this guitar track, let's push this up to +3, and you can see that indicated right there. So I think I saved the best for last, and that's actually to use the limiter effect, which is a plugin, and put that on the final main output bus. And here's how I do that. I go over to the mixer, hit the plus button, choose dynamics, Fairlight effects, limiter, and this is the tool. It's really, really simple to use. I'm gonna explain it. So limit, this section here is your threshold. Because we want to stay under the negative 1.5 decibels true peak, we're going to change this to negative 2. So that gives us just a little bit of extra headroom, half a decibel. And the next one to it is going to be our gain. So if we're not hitting that enough to bring everything up, we can increase our gain on this level right here to get to that negative 14. Now, if we take a listen to our video.
So faith is rising up. I grabbed Nate.
We've got an integrated reading right here. And it's about, you know, 1.5 low. So we could easily push our level up. Now, a lot of times you would do this while playing back, but I'm just trying to talk and explain it. So maybe we push this up to 2.4 or something. This is hopefully going to get us closer to the integrated reading that we're looking for. And
so faith is rising up. I grabbed Nate and I was like, hey,
I'm pulling that down so I can talk better. But basically, if you see it crossing this blue, it's basically it's getting affected. It's getting limited. But it's protecting those without clipping, which is super helpful. And if you check out up over here, we're in that negative 14 ballpark, that yellow zone that we want to be at. So we're not in the blue zone. We're in the yellow zone, which is great for YouTube. And we haven't gone over into the red. And also our true peak up here is being limited and taken care of under that negative 1.5 or negative 1.8, which is great. So that's the limiter effect. I highly suggest that you use it on pretty much anything you send to YouTube because it just lets you get that integrated level up so easily. There's also another way to look at loudness here in Resolve in the Fairlight page, and that's with the loudness histogram. The way you get to that is by clicking the automation button that's right here, not to be confused with the transient detection button that's below it. So choose automation. And that has now just made the bus track available, visible on our main timeline here. If you just drag this down a little bit, you'll see there's more to it. So just drag that down in the header, check the loudness history button, and choose integrated, because we're always looking at integrated loudness. And you can see I had previous graph here from doing this before. But if you go back to the beginning of your timeline, it will begin drawing the loudness history over the course of your playback, just like the one up above, where it's giving you yellow if it's in the right ballpark. Red right there was a little bit hot, but it's pulled back down to yellow, and it's bumped right up around negative 14. So we can see this video is pretty much all set and good to go for YouTube. Now I've got a quick question for you. Can you please drop a comment with your experience level using Resolve, beginner, intermediate, or Jedi? That way I can make better future videos for you in the future. Also, if you're coming from another editing platform, put that in the comments. That's gonna help me out a ton. Hey, if you want more videos like this, click on the DaVinci Resolve playlist on screen right now for more tutorials. And because there's so much more to learn, I'll see you in the next video.